He says, وَحَاجَتُهُمْ إِلَيْهَا i.e. إِلَى الْهِدَايَةِ And our need to be guided أَعْذَمُ مِنْ حَاجَتِهِمْ إِلَى الطَّعَامِ is more greater than our need for وَعَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامُ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ is more greater than our need for food وَالشَّرَابِ and drink. لِمَاذَا يَا شَيْخ Why is our haja, our need to be guided to the straight path more important than our need for food and drink? The Shaykh says, لِأَنَّ الطَّعَامَ وَالشَّرَابَ سَبَبُ بَقَائِهِمْ فِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا Our eating and our drinking is the reason for our existence, if you like, and the fact that we can remain alive in this world. If you don't eat and you don't drink, you will die, right? You will die in this dunya. وَأَمَّا هِدَايَتُهُمْ أَصِرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ As it relates to being guided to the straight path, فَهِيَ السَّبَبُ فَلَاحِهِمْ وَسَعَادَتِهِمْ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ But as it relates to being guided to the straight path, not only is it a reason for us to be successful and for us to be happy in this life, but we're also Abu Ibn Adil, hereafter as well. So Hidayah will give us, inshallah, happiness and success and contentment in this life and the hereafter. But as it relates to food and drink, then it's only feeding our shells. Again, I just got it just now. Wallahi, akhi, just hit me just now. The eating and the drinking that sustains our body is merely just supporting this shell that you see in front of us today. That insignificant, superficial thing that so many of us judge each other by on a daily basis. Wallahu al-musta'an. Na'am. Waqt al-salah. Man. Ya akhi, my salt, I've been speaking for an hour. You want me to call adhan? Bismillah. Mutashaddid huwa. من لا يرحم لا يرحم أخي. I want you to get أجل as well. لا يح لا 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 إيش الحديث لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه فيحب لأخيه تفضل أخي بسم الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آت محمد الوسيلة والفضيلة وبارك المقام المحمود الذي وعد بسم الله والصلاة والسلام بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله أما بعد طيب إخوان What was the last thing that we finished on? What's the last thing we mentioned before we... ممتاز So we know that this is from اختلاف التنوع varying wordings but there is unification in the meaning Now, alhamdulillah, inshallah ta'ala, we've got 5 minutes, we're going to finish Fatiha today so we can move on to the next rukun, inshallah ta'ala, by next lesson. Khalas, let's go on. Alright, I'm just going to quickly read what the Shaykh says here about ikhtilaf al-tanawwa' because I think it's very important. He's speaking about, he does mention the fact that we're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance it shouldn't just be merely we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guidance and that's it, but we also want to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to increase us in guidance. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah to Muhammad, he says at verse number 17, he says, وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدَى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ, which can translate to mean, and those who were guided, زَادَهُمْ هُدَى, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, زَادَهُمْ in guidance. He increased them in guidance. وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ, and he gave them التَّقْوَى. Then the Shaykh says, أَسِرَاطُ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ بِالْأَفْوَانِ, he says, وَلَا تُنَافِي بَيْنَ تَفْسِيرِ إِهْدِنَا بِدُلُّنَا وَأَرَشِدْنَا وَثَبِّتْنَا وَتَفْسِيرُ الصَّلَاةِ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ بِالْإِسْلَامِ وَالرَّسُولِ وَالْقُرْآنِ لِأَنَّ ذَلِكَ مِنْ قَبِيلِ اخْتِلَافِ التَّنَوُّعِ وَلَيْسَ مِنْ قَبِيلِ اخْتِلَافِ التَّضَادِ وَلِهَذَا قَالَ شَيْخ الْكُلُّ حَقٌّ. He says here, when we say إِهْدِنَا can mean دُلُّنَا, or it can mean أَرْشِدْنَا, or it can mean ثَبِّتْنَا, and when we say that the Sirat al-Mustaqim means al-Islam, or it can mean al-Rasul, or it can mean al-Qur'an, there is no difference, alaykum salam wa rahmatullah wa barakatuh, there's no difference between all of these words, because this is from اختلاف التنوع, various wordings, but there's unification in meaning, and it's not from the type of اختلاف التضاد, whereby the words and the meanings are different. And it's for this reason, Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab says in the original book, الكل حق, all of them are true. And this is oftentimes what you saw from the, or what we see from the tafsir of the Salaf. They would use different words to explain the same thing. All right, I'm going to move on to the last ayah, where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says, move on to the last ayah, where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين, the path of those who أنعمت عليهم, that you, Allah, have bestowed your blessings upon, not like those who have earned your anger, nor those who have gone astray. Time doesn't permit me to ask you guys what is intended by those who have been blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and those who have the anger of Allah, and those who have gone astray. So I'm going to answer it now. Those people that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has bestowed His blessings on, we know who they are from another ayah in the Quran, wherein Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this is in Surah An-Nisa'i, verse number 69. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yaqul, وَمَن يُطِعِ اللَّهَ والرسول فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and whomsoever obeys Allah and the Messenger, فَأُولَٰئِكَ, then those people, i.e. those people that obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger, they will be with those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala an'ama alayhim, those that Allah has blessed. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes on to explain who He has blessed, the groups or the categories of people that He has blessed. Number one, an-nabiyyin, from the prophets. Number two, as-siddiqeen, those people that are truthful. Number three, as-shuhada, those people that have died in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number four, as-salihin, the righteous. Those are the people that when we say, صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم, the path of those whom you have bestowed your grace, we're speaking about those four categories of people. And this is example of تفسير القرآن بالقرآن. تفسير القرآن بالقرآن, explaining the Qur'an using another verse in the Qur'an to explain it. Alright guys, who are the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry with? They are none other than al-Yahud. Why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala angry with the Yahud? Because they have ilm, knowledge, but they don't act upon their knowledge. They have knowledge, but they don't act upon it. And those people that have gone astray, who are they? They are none other than an-Nasara. يَعْبُدُونَ اللَّهَ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَلَى جَهْلٍ وَالضَّلَالِ. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon ignorance and misguidance. And to conclude, ikhwani wa akhawati fillah, when we finish al-Fatiha, it's a dua, we say ameen, ameen. And ameen is a word that we use to mean, oh Allah, please accept. Oh Allah, please accept. And I'll finish on this because it's 35 we pray today, right? All right. Okay, I'll finish on this one. Oftentimes in the month of Ramadan, all right, when we stand for Salat al-Tarawih, when the Imam finishes the raka'at and he starts to make a dua, oftentimes the Imam isn't making dua, he is praising Allah. O Allah, to you belong the dominions of the heavens and the earth. O Allah, to you belong all praise. O Allah, you are the, and you praising Allah constantly. And what happens sometimes, and this is none other, Allah knows best, than one of two reasons. Number one, ignorance of the Arabic language. Or number two, being heedless of what's actually being said, even if you understand the Arabic language. Lacking spirituality and concentration and tarakiz in your salah. That even if you know that the Imam isn't asking Allah for anything, you still say Ameen, Ameen, because you're just following everybody else saying Ameen. And then you check yourself and realize, wait, he never asked Allah for anything such that I said Ameen. He was praising Allah. So if I say to you, for example, Alhamdulillah, who from among us will say Ameen? That don't make no sense. If I said, all praise is due to Allah, Ameen. Oh Allah, give us Jannah. Oh Allah, accept our fast. Oh Allah, cause us to die either as shuhada or sadiqeen. This is dua. But if I praise Allah and say, oh Allah, to you belong the dominions of the heavens and the earth and everything that is in between, the Muslim doesn't say ameen to that. So we should try to be mindful when we're praying, coming up in Ramadan during Taraweeh, not to say ameen if we don't have to say ameen. How are you going to know when to say ameen if you don't understand the Arabic language? Allah al-musta'an. Learn it.
People follow other people,
but that could be dangerous.
But people don't know they're saying ameen anyway. So people just say, oh, if he's saying it, he must be right.
Exactly. Maybe just try to stand next to somebody that speaks Arabic. So that's a bid'ah. That's a bid'ah. That's a bid'ah. That's a bid'ah. Nah. Before you pray, don't ask the person next to you to speak Arabic. That's a bid'ah. That's a bid'ah. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Jazakumullahu khair, ikhwan, for your attendance and your attentiveness. I don't have a charger, actually. You have a charger? I don't have a charger, so sorry.